The potter may cut his clay, from which the pots are to be made, from long rolls, and each piece must be knocked with the heel of one hand, until the clay is shaped so. The clay ball is thrown as near to the center of the wheel as possible, before the process of centering the clay begins. Feet apart, thumbs crossed, hands crossed. And finally, the centering is completed with the formation of this shape. The clay must now be held. Care must be taken lest the potter goes through to the wheel. The finger of the right hand is straightened, whilst the left hand serves to support the revolving form, and so keep it in the center of the wheel. The hole is widened. The wheel is made to revolve more slowly now, for we are about to lift the thick clay walls, trimming them as they grow in height. The first lift is made by drawing the clay up between the thumb and knuckle of the index finger of the right hand. Here we see a section through the pot at this stage. A second lift draws the pot higher. Surplus clay at the bottom of the cylinder is now trimmed away. Two different shaped tools are used for this purpose. Note the position of the hands and elbows. The wheel is stopped. The top cut from the wheel and placed on a plough. Here we see three sections through the top at the various stages of construction. Put them through the whole procedure. The hole is widened, ready for the first and second lift, which will carry the pot to its intended height and form.